And you know, everybody's talking about the good old days, right? Everybody, the good old days, the good old days. Well, let's talk about the good old days. Come to think of it, as bad as we think they are, these will become the good old days for our children. But why don't we try to remember that kind of September when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember. And if you remember, then follow. Oh, what does it seem that the past is always better? We look back and we think the winters were warmer, the grass was greener, the skies were bluer, and smiles were bright.
The past always looks better than it was. It's only pleasant because it isn't here. As business people, we must always think of the future, because that's the future. That's where we plan to do business. And Hendersonville was given the tool by the North Carolina legislature to move from the past to the future, with enabling legislation to permit the establishment of special purpose tax districts. Mayor Boyce Whitmire and City Council appointed a Downtown Committee. A Downtown Committee to establish the special tax district and to develop a revitalization plan. Jody and Mary Barber, D.B. Keith, Charles Waters, Sam McGirt, Kermit Edney, with professional assistance from Emery Jackson, Wayne Towers, and our planner, David Quinn. Utilizing an existing plan which had been proposed in 1964, architect Emery Jackson, at no cost, adapted the Serpentine plan with a park-like concept to the downtown area of Hendersonville. With the assistance of engineers in the water department, underground facilities were inventoried in advance so that not only would the new plan provide new features, but also would upgrade existing services and correct long-standing problems with water, drainage, and high and low curbs in the area. While Main Street Hendersonville had experienced every form of vehicle movement and storage, parking on the sides, in the center of, parallel, and diagonal to, Commissioner R.B. Sheely felt that the Serpentine was so unusual it should be put to an actual test before implemented. So, prior to the Christmas season, in 1975, the center line was repainted to conform to the Serpentine configuration. Where future planters and sidewalk extensions would go, bumpers were placed in outline form, and huge Christmas trees were donated by Sinclair Nursery to simulate the various planters. The flow of traffic, and with the imagination of an Alfred Hitchcock, you could even visualize what the park might ultimately look like. City Council authorized City Police Chief Bill Powers and Water Department Executive Bill Lapsley to work as co-managers for the city in working with Jody Barber and the Downtown Committee to implement the plan. Through 1977, the Downtown Committee was involved in 108 formal meetings with the most unusual, voluntary working relationship ever established between the city and its employees and the merchants and the community leaders of Hendersonville. A $500 donation by Frank Todd, now our mayor, permitted the city to build a demonstration planter at the corner of 5th and Main. No trenching had been done at this time, and the conduits were only placed to connect beyond the planter when and if the project would ever be approved. It was a good learning experience. On that first planter, the sidewalk and extensions were poured first, and the planter built later. It was found it was less expensive to reverse the procedure, and wood in the later planters to be built. Our beautification subcommittee recommended that we use a sarvis tree in the first planter, a native tree with many beautiful features. And we learned from that also. The Beautification Committee ultimately recommended, for many reasons, the planting of linden trees instead. Again, the project stayed alive with community support. Students from Blue Ridge Tech donated their time to complete the planting and to have at least one planter alive and well as the Downtown Committee continued their work on selling the entire concept of the plan. Again, to encourage the Downtown Committee in its work in the period before permanent financing could be arranged, The mayor and the city of Hendersonville budgeted from city funds for the purpose of assisting in getting the project started the sum of $20,000. As the trenching for buried conduits proceeded south on the east side of Main Street, city employees did all the work, relocating water meters, installing larger underground surface drains on a number of the avenues in the downtown area. Employees of the city, under the supervision of our Bills, Bill Powers and Bill Lapsley, installed the various conduits to carry water, electricity, telephone, and sound systems. It would be impossible to determine just how much money the cooperation of the city and its employees did save this project. However, because work to be done by the city employees was scheduled in conjunction with regular responsibilities that they already had, the work progressed more slowly than hoped for, and there developed unrest with the muss and fuss in the downtown area. And the problems of the unknown, which also was a factor in trying to avoid letting the project to contract. After all, if we didn't know what sort of problems we'd hit, the contractor would have to factor his bid on the same unknowns. In building the express parking areas, we discovered that some firms had basements extending under the sidewalk. And special reinforced concrete slabs had to be built over these areas before they could be given a rough asphalt treatment, which would later be given a finished paving when the overall street surface was paved. Well, these were rather discouraging days during the project. In lieu of performance, about this time, we resorted to promises with signs. But the faith of some of our merchants kept us going. In spite of the fact that our shopping park was primarily only in the minds of dreamers, folks like Houston Furniture Company believed in what we were doing, believed enough to begin installing a new front to their building. And at last, with conduits buried and make-ready complete, the park can begin taking shape with the construction of the planters. And by this time, the committee formally decided the name of the downtown area should be the Downtown Shopping Park. Oh, we were still running into problems, like having to cut through the steel rails of the old Columbia Park Electric Railway, which had been buried for years under the cement in front of the courthouse, and which were discovered when working on the block between 1st and 2nd. And to save even more money, the old stone curbing, which had been removed from portions of Main Street, were recycled and became the cap of a new decorative stone wall in front of the courthouse. By this time, our people could begin to visualize that the shopping park was indeed beginning to take shape, as every week, more and more planters were completed, and the first efforts of Diana Parham and the Beautification Committee could be seen in all their beauty. Final stages of the project saw the installation, right in the middle of Diana's flowers, of the decorative lighting and the mushroom speakers for the background music to be used in the future. And who can add up all the hours the Beautification Committee donated in their many, many planning sessions, seeking to select not only the brightest and prettiest flowers, but trees especially suited for a downtown area. Makeshift nursery facilities were established in an old hothouse located near 9th Avenue School. Joe Brandt of the Beautification Committee and Josephine Kentup and Grace Garrett and Marguerite Runk and Chairman Mary Barber worked with Diana to jerry-rig the abandoned facility into something we could get along with. And while Diana received the title of City Gardener, she roared on her coveralls as she found it necessary to actually carry out the chores she was also supervising. And the park concept of the downtown does require year-round planning and planting and pruning and perseverance and patience and maybe even a little prayer. But any time you'd feel discouraged, something big and inspiring would happen, like the Hendersonville Board of Realtors offering the gift of a gazebo to house special activities in the park.
Wowie, zowie!
First opening of the park last year when Chairman Jody Barber pledged the use of the new facility named in the contest Top of the Park for the use of the people of the area. And then a gift of $500 from the American Association of Retired People for a new 24-hour-a-day illuminated flagpole, and the flag a gift from Sir Toma Club. As old Senator Dudley J. LeBlanc of Hattacall fame used to say, He don't care what they say about him, as long as they keep talking about him. And here, we can see that the Times News certainly kept people talking. Everybody suddenly discovered or rediscovered our Main Street. And all of a sudden, everybody had an interest in Main Street, Hendersonville. There might have been some doubt about the keenness of their interest before efforts on the park started, when we had five major store buildings standing empty for lack of customers. Older folks didn't like the change. The kids hated to lose their drag strip. And then there are always those who would enjoy being around at the end of time just to see the show. And they felt that folly on Main Street might give us a sneak preview. Even TV got in the act. An editorial writer at Channel 13, known for a degree of pomposity, observed that what Hendersonville was doing was purely cosmetic and would be of short-term value. Hendersonville is still here, but don't tune in tomorrow for that editorial writer on Channel 13. The real test of the survival of downtown Hendersonville depends on the merchants and their willingness to provide the type of stores, the goods, and the services the people want. All the beauty and convenience in the world cannot do for merchants what they have to do for themselves. And our merchants started doing. Houston Furniture Company had acquired the old Gregg Hardware Building, an empty eyesore for many years, and extended their modern facade over it. Right across the street, Carl Morris made a big move and totally remodeled the standard commercial front, which had been the home food shop, and created a charming and delightful facade. The McClellan store building, at one time a real anchor in the busiest part of the business section, which had become empty, was acquired and totally remodeled into a different operation, four store buildings on two levels named the Savannah House. And what was at one time an old A&P corner grocery store at Main at First was acquired by Burt Browning III, totally renovated outside and in, including living quarters upstairs, and now serves as home of Browning Galleries. And this effort was nominated for achievement by the local business and professional women's club and won second place in state competition. Well, it's the summer of 77, and the park will really take shape as resurfacing of the entire area takes place, covering over the rough finish of the express parking, blanketing all the trenching work that had now been completed. The serpentine lines were added, and with special imaginative effect, even the crosswalk lines. So, at last, 2 years from the start, the bulk of the major change in Main Street, Hendersonville, is complete. And the serpentine pattern, slowing traffic, protecting shoppers with adequate crosswalks, never having to cross more than two lanes of traffic, handicapped ramps, easy diagonal parking, serpentine's complete. And each month that passed in 1977, and each flower that bloomed in every planter, caused people to look, and look, and look again, and like the park better. But from the very start, planners and the downtown committee knew that the major problem in the downtown was not just high-speed traffic, but lack of parking. Based on the original plan, buildings from the alleys to both Church and King Street were acquired, first by the Downtown Parking Corporation, headed by D.D. Keith, and then transferred to the city and torn down for parking. With the old blighted buildings torn down, the area can breathe again. In just 2 years, the rows of buildings that years ago used to house Dave Stokes and Sons awning all came down and became a parking lot. The professional building on 4th, the old Texaco building, Church at 4th, the McCallion building, new parking acquired on Church between 2nd and 3rd, and a new lot from the Bowen family to enlarge the biggest downtown lot for the church. And since the project started, over 179 spaces have been added for off-street parking. Now the city, had they kept US 25 on Old Main Street, would have today only had 95 parking spaces in the Main Street area. Today, there are three times as many parking places in off-street parking as there would have been in Main Street parking. And the way is shown for what merchants and store owners need to do to the rear of their stores, where parking has now replaced the old dilapidated buildings, in this effort by Dan Barber at Western Auto and the Uphams at the Added Touch. A vital, very vital part of whether or not the shopping park is successful is the merchants' generous use of parking tokens. Store patrons still find no thrill in paying a nickel or a dime to shop in your store. A parking token can be the best business getter in the downtown shopping park. And there must be activity in the park. Main Street USA was born with the feeling that it was always exciting to go downtown. An initial effort toward scheduling of activities last year will be intensified this year. For regardless of whether it was a dance team, a sidewalk art show, a motorama, free watermelon, skateboard contest, whatever special activity, it never failed to rekindle interest in Let's Go Downtown. So, here in the city of Four Seasons, Hendersonville does now have a healthy, thriving heartbeat. And whether it's in the beauty of springtime, giving way to blooming rhododendrons, or marigolds, or geraniums, or even in the winter season in our city of Four Seasons. With the generous help of the city of Hendersonville, the unbelievably small sum of under $200,000 in taxes from the tax district, and the hundreds of thousands of volunteer man hours, Hendersonville has made the transition from the old to the new, the downtown shopping park. All the major empty buildings are now filled, new fronts and interiors are being installed. Well, the shopping park may not have been the total reason for all the renewed interest in downtown, but it is a change. And as Washington Irving once said, there is relief in change, even though it could be from bad to worse, as I've found in traveling in a stagecoach. It is often a comfort to shift one's position and be bruised in a new place.